was 49 in the car. It might be in the mid 50s, but it's not warm. I brought a spare long sleeve shirt in case it's too cold.
Really crisp day rolling down this trail.
I gotta put on another shirt.
Put on another
shirt? Yep. Yep.
Jeff and Tom took the pie trail, but I'm gonna take it easy for a little bit till I warm up. We're heading up towards the northeast end where the big landfill is. Now we're on the south side of Burma Road, heading up essentially a haul road. Jeff has already gone down this trail. I'll let Tom go in front of me, mostly to have some orange color in front of the video. This is not really single track, but you don't see that many side-by-sides on it. Tom's going down So you can turn around and come back up the hill. Oops, didn't quite make it.
You should just ride down again.
Yep. He means like completely turn, yeah. Like, yeah.
Keep going.
Do that? Yeah.
This is the hard lift when you're more than 90 degrees
you're
over. Wow, good job. That's work, man. Makes it look easy this time. The temperature is really nice now in the sun. It may only be 55 or 60, but it feels great. This little hill proceeds to get harder and harder for me every time I ride it. That didn't have enough momentum. Now I'm stuck.
Gravel plant.
We take a quick transit on the pavement. It's about a quarter mile. Actually, you can't see the gravel plant, but I could see the trees. Now the main trail here is closed, so we're trying a new trail. Looks like they've just cut it in. Taking it easy because I have no idea what's ahead of me. So we're just going to putt down this trail. Hopefully it's just parallel to the main haul road. not clear where the trail goes here, so I'm just pressing on. Now we're down at the bottom of the valley.
There's a little bit of drama getting out, huh?
Yeah, so where are we now?
If we go up here and take a right, we head down to the pipe stem.
But we don't go to the pipe stem, we just head up the straightway. Now, off to the right is the closed down area. I think they're rehabbing it or regrading it. So we'll go up to the usual Meadows Overlook power line circle. Well, the bypass for this puddle is blocked, so I'm just going to go through the puddle. It's only about 6-8 inches deep, not a big deal. And here we are at Heights Broken Back Waterfall. This is Nothing Hill, which usually is nothing, but sometimes I get offline and run over rocks and have it be a bit more thrilling than it's supposed to be. And pretty straightforward today. We're going to try to do Rich's famous secret single track, which we have failed to ride the last couple times because we get lost. Maybe that's why it's secret. Starts here. Okay. We go down a little bit and hang a quick right. So far, so good.
I know. It never feels right, does it? It feels like we should be out there.
No, I'm pretty sure we have to go here.
A month or so ago, this was completely overgrown. You couldn't see anything. And it's just not clear if we're on a trail or not.
I don't think this is the right way. Yep.
Well, this is some trail. It's worn in a little bit. But it doesn't feel right. It doesn't feel like the trail that we want to be on. No, I recognize that tree and root ball, so this is another trail that we used to ride all the time. Not the one we were looking for, but any trail in the woods, you know. I know where this one goes. So we're higher up than we would be if we'd made the right trail, which comes in a couple hundred yards farther down here, but it still worked, so life is good.
Now
we don't want to take my trail now.
Okay.
We want to take, I think, the old one. Mine's got to be completely overgrown at this point.
Yeah. Now I don't see the swing line mast. The trees are still up a little bit. This trail doesn't feel as rocky as it usually does. I wonder if somebody's dragged it a little bit. And the bulldozer that used to sit next to the drag line has been cleared out, and several other pieces of old bulldozer equipment have been removed.
A little break maybe at Casca?
Yeah, well, I'm gonna need a new battery.
Okay.
This new camera eats batteries
apparently
badly. Yeah.
So it was interesting to see the old bulldozers just sitting out here rusting. We'd heard that they'd been untouched. They ran when parked, but that was over 10 years ago. And I would expect that they're just too valuable to ignore and let rust away. This is a little minor side loop. Jeff and I have been taking it a couple times recently. It all goes to the same place. It just slightly different rocks, different trees. Well, this downed tree has bothered me, so I get out my saw and cut it off to make it a lot easier to follow this trail. Now we're coming out of the woods and back onto Eagle Hill Road, which goes down to Silver Creek Road. For being an official county road, it sure has a lot of rocks on it. We're coming up on Silver Creek, the creek, and...
Good grief!
The pond is gone. I think that there was a dam that collected it into a fairly modest, you know, 20 feet by 10 feet pond, but now it's just a little tiny creek bed. No water at all, hardly. But we still have rocks. These roads, they're clearly roads, have very noticeable sewer manhole covers popping up. Somebody put a lot of money into putting in a sewer system. And then they never developed the land. Now we're heading up to the Triple Pond. This is the dam for the Triple Pond. Well, I guess this is the dam for the Triple Pond. That Jeff is up, and I'm going up. And you can see the three ponds. noticeably drier today than usual. Some of these sections that are usually very swampy or just have small puddles. Coming back to the creek at Silver Creek, which is just a tiny, tiny stream of water, but you can see the mud flats from when it used to be a pond. And crossing Silver Creek Road again. Climbing Nothing Hill. I think I've got enough momentum to make this work. And back to the trailhead.